Hello students, today we are going to do a poem in Unit 5, The Secret of the Machines by Rudyard Kipling. Before we begin with the poem, let me give you a note on the poet. Now Rudyard Kipling was born on December 30th, 1865 in Bombay, in India. He was educated in England but returned to India in 1882. A decade later, that means after 10 years, Kipling married Caroline Ballister and settled in Brattleboro, Vermont, where he wrote The Jungle Book. Have you seen the famous movie The Jungle Book? It was written by him, among a host of other works that made him hugely successful. Kipling was the recipient of the 1907 Nobel Prize in Literature and he died in 1936. Now here in The Secret of the Machines, the poem deals with the problem of modern technology and automation. Today we are using a lot of machines in our day-to-day life to make work easier for us and to make work faster. In the beginning, we get only information about how machines are produced and what kind of treatment they need. Afterwards, the machines explain, okay? They explain how they can serve humanity. And the poem ends with a statement that machines, although capable of great deeds, are still nothing else but a creation from the human brain that man has created. All right? So here the poet is giving the personification. Clearly it is a full personification where the machines are given a human attribute. So let's start with the beginning. The machines are talking here. We were taken from the obed and the mine. We were melted in the furnace and the pit. We were cast and wrought and hammered to design. We were cut and filed and tooled and gauged to fit. So they were taken from the obed means from the natural source, from the rock. All right? The metal is taken first and made into a machine. First it's taken from the mines. They are extracted and taken from the mines. And then they were melted in the furnace, in the fire. They were melted and then only, then they were created with a huge huge tools. They were cast and wrought and hammered using tools, hammers. Okay, they were cut and filed, shaped, and tooled and gauged to fit. Then, what do they need? Some water, coal, and oil is all we ask. What does the machine need? It only needs a little water, coal, and oil that they have to move. Like how we take food, the machines need the water, coal, and oil, and a thousandth of an inch to give us play. And now, if you will set us to our task, we will serve you 24 hours a day. So if you feed the machine with the necessary requirements that it needs, the water, coal and oil, then they will start beginning their work. And they will serve you, they will serve us for long hours, for more than 24 hours. We can pull and haul and push and lift and drive. So here the machine is saying what all they can do. They can pull and haul. Haul means to lift up. And to push and lift and drive. We can print and plow and weave and heat and light. So various machines are made. Some are used for pulling and pushing like cranes to lift objects. Then the printers, you know, we use to print things. Then plow that is used on the field. Weave is nothing else but the loom that we weave cloth, the weaving machine. Heat, the machines that produce heat and light for us, the bulb. And we can run and race and swim and fly and drive. So this is all the movements of the machine. They can run and race and swim and fly and drive. And dive also. We use cars, automobiles. We use aeroplanes, so they can even fly. We can see and hear and count and read and write. So the machines that we use to see, to hear, the machines that we use for music, to hear, to count, and to read and write, the calculators and the computers. But remember, please, the law by which we live, we are not built to comprehend a lie. So the law that they live by is, they are not made as false, but it is only made by man. We can neither love nor pity nor forgive. They cannot be like human beings and transmit love or pity, feel sad or have any emotions. If you make a slip in handling us, you die. So whatever the machines, they are not like human beings. They just keep on moving and they keep on working. They have no feelings or emotions. So if the person who is using the machine makes a mistake, a slip in handling it, they will die. So these huge machines, they are saying, we cannot be like humans, we have no emotions. So if you make a mistake in handling us, you will die. Through our smoke may hide the heavens from your eyes. It will vanish and the stars will shine again. Because for all our power and weight and size, we are nothing more than children of your brain. So here in the last stanza, the machines are saying that through all the smoke, whatever is going on in the factory with these machines, it will vanish. The stars will still shine again. Because for all our power and weight and size, whatever power and weight and size we have, we are nothing more than a creation of yours. That means you have made us. You humans have made us. And it is because of your brain, your wisdom and your knowledge that we are created. We are created by you. So the last stanza, the machine tells us, we are nothing more than only a creation from man's brain. Now let us go to the poetic devices in the poem, children. If you see the first four lines, we were taken from the obed and the mine. We were melted in the furnace and the pit. We were cast and wrought and hammered to design. We were cut and filed and tooled and gauged to fit. So here are these four lines, mine and design rhyme, pit and fit. So your rhyme scheme will be A, B, A, B. Again, the second stanza. Some water, coal and oil is all we ask, and a thousand of an inch to give us play. And now if you will set us to our task, we will serve you 24 hours a day. So ask and task, play and day. Again, A, B, A, B. So the rhyme scheme employed in the full poem is A, B, A, B. Then coming to the other poetic devices, we have the imagery, that is the description which creates a picture in the reader's mind. We can see, hear, count, read and write. So it's giving us a clear picture. The example explains us the many tasks that could be completed by the machine. All right. Then the machine is given a human attribute. Okay. It is a non-living thing, but it is given a human. So that is personification. I told you the full poem is a personification. We can pull and haul and push and lift and drive. So this personification is a figure of speech in which a thing or an idea is a non-living thing is given a human attribute. Then we come to the hyperbole. A figure of speech using exaggeration, over-exaggeration. We are greater than the peoples and the kings. So it's exaggerating. The machines are saying we are greater because we are so capable of doing so much of work. We are greater than the peoples and the kings. Then we have the repetition of two or more vowel sounds. Assonance. All we ask. A. All and A ask. Just like the alliteration. Then we also have the simile, which is comparing the machine. The machine is comparing itself greater than the people of the kings. So once more, you read the poem thoroughly, children, learn it by heart, and then you learn the figures of speech. Coming to the glossary, furnace, I told you, is something very hot, an enclosed structure in which material is heated to a very high temperature. You see, glass and metal are all heated. gold and all these metals are all heated in the furnace. Rot, that means beaten out of shape by hammering. Okay, when we make things, they use the hammer to shape it. Gauge, an instrument that measures and gives a visual display of the amount, level or contents of something. Gauge means a fitting. It gives it a shape. Next, 1,000, it means a fracture of 1,000. Haul, to pull or drag with effort or force. Comprehend means grasp or understand. So the machine cannot grasp anything or understand anything. Vanish. Vanish means to disappear suddenly and completely. So after this, you can do the exercises. Learn the poem for memory by heart and then do the exercises behind the poem.